Ladies and gentlemen, this next band of the evening is sponsored by Clellan Joinery and Property Services and takes place in the World Bantamweight Division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing SPG Tullamore, Ronan Deegan! Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner and representing C-Mac, Jordan
Here we go, Paul. Will we call it the main card?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
The main card.
We're at the top end. We've got seven fights left to go on this monster card here at Uhr 4. Ronan Deegan, of course, already in the cage in the lovely Offaly Ga themed shorts.
This is the alternate version.
Yeah, the away kit.
Yeah.
Deegan had a good win by submission here on the last event against Paddy Doran.
They're an awfully nice pair of shorts.
He didn't.
I just did. Here we go.
Deegan only started fighting in October of last year and has four fights under his belt already. Three wins by submission. Chasing a triangle here. Very aggressively. That's a very experienced opponent here, of course. Bradshaw has 15 fights already. Says he wants 30 before going pro.
That's a nice figure.
Nice round number.
It's nice to hear him say, nice to hear someone say something like that instead of rushing to the pro ranks.
Yeah. Bradshaw says he trains twice a day. He's fighting since 2016. He was also on the last Euro card and he won a great rematch, you'll remember, against Rory Burke. An absolutely cracking fight.
So, earlier on in a previous fight, Chris Fields called this position the Maya. I assume after Damian Maya, but he wanted both feet on the knees. Kieran Davern comes from a
both
modern...
Both knees on the ground, you mean?
Both knees on the ground, sorry. Kieran Davern was, like, guiding him into this position here of, like, the leg drag, nice body lock position. But he seemed to be very tight even with that posting left leg. It's nice to see some modern influences coming into the game.
Absolutely, yeah.
It's nice to see the leg drag position being utilised. Leg drag and half guard are becoming very meta in the MMA world at the moment. And of course, this triangle.
Deegan, of course, as I said, three wins already by submission, so no slouch on the ground here. Great MMA grappling on display so far. Loving this pressure.
Nice wrist control on the way to the back.
Look at the way he just climbed up from the lower legs of Bradshaw all the way to the back mount of body triangle.
Nice body triangle and the left leg extending on the calf as well on the inside. Kieran Davern's looking for a couple of strikes. Keep the underhook strike with the other hand. And hopefully that would open up the throat for him. 1 minute left of this first round.
Really impressive, inch by inch, climbing up and grappling into a dominant position here. What can Bradshaw do in response? Left leg beautifully, just to stretch out his opponent.
Slept
not
because
to bridge, which he's trying to do now to get.
Do you know, I
pressure.
One time training before with Max Lally, he showed me a brilliant transition that he learned over in the States from that body triangle. Now, when you have the limb length that Ronan has, this is perfect. But it's the other thing that was shown to me was just designed to stop the person generating the momentum going side to side. But nice control here from Ronan Deegan.
Dominant first round display.
Oh, thought there was a bit of a limp there at the start. I'm not sure. Seems all good. He got a good stretch of the leg anyway.
He looked like he was going to hop to the wrong corner. Both guys straight into the middle without the referee. Referee didn't start the round, so a little too eager. But now we're in action. Bradshaw wants to get out and start landing his strikes and get himself a little foothold in this bout.
Oh, nice tape from Bradshaw there, straight to the body.
Yeah, and a lovely straight left just there.
Saw that one coming.
Dodges out of there effectively and back to the centre, and Egan's up on the toes. He just wants that takedown, doesn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. And Ronan swapped his stance two or three times in this round already. His feints are a little bit unorthodox to seem to set up his takedown attempts well. Two open palm shots there from Bradshaw to annoy him a little bit.
Yeah, we're seeing grappler against striker really here.
Yeah, that's lovely. We've seen that a few times earlier on against the cage where somebody drives the knee in between to cause a separation.
Suffocating pressure here again from Deegan. Beautiful pass, although that knee shield is still in there from Bradshaw.
It's a nice overhook from Bradshaw here that's frustrating, and we could see a triangle attempt coming here. Yeah. Nice right hand control on the bicep, but Deegan's doing a great job of flattening that leg out. Now we're back into the half guard. This is a very technical battle between both. A lot going on, small micro battles, you could say.
Yeah, the little switch of the hips there was nice and Deegan just to shift his base. He's kind of into that reverse half guard position and slaps on the back here of no use whatsoever. But Bradshaw looks, get the butterfly hook in. He can elevate his opponent, get a little bit of space. That shoulder crush.
Yeah, that's an interesting grip there.
Sitting in on those hips and stacking his opponent, and now using that to transition to the back again.
Yeah, that's a sequence I always like to see when a person's thrown the shots from the standing but is also focused on passing their legs, knowing that the rotation is going to bring their opponent up to the knees and they're already moving around to look for the back. Nice work from Ronan Deegan. Bradshaw's been a lot more competitive in this round than the first He didn't have to spend as much of the round in this body triangle that we're seeing close out the round for the second time. And once again, excellent work from Rory Lavery and Shea Cleland, cage technicians over there. Look at that. Look at that workmanship. Wow.
Beautiful.
Brilliant work.
Expert level.
Brilliant work. Great work, Shea. Good man.
Much more competitive second round, although you could see a case here where Deegan may be up two rounds, so Bradshaw will definitely be looking to keep this one on the feet as long as he can. Did quite well with that in the early parts of round two.
Oh, the Polish viewers are logging on. They must be getting ready for the main event of the evening. Poland's own, also Nuri's own, Marcin Zembala, fighting in Ireland for the first time as a pro since 2018.
Wow. Yeah, really looking forward to that bout against Alex Yankov. Both guys really eager to get going again. This time they're going to wait for the ref. And we're away. And look, Bradshaw just wants to start landing these strikes. This is where he wants to bout. He wants to try and keep himself on the feet, keep a little space, do work like this, and we can see why. Very effective, but look at Deegan. In on that leg, in deep on that single leg attempt.
Nice step out. This is lovely head control from Bradshaw here. It might put Deegan off it.
Scrambles back off that failed hip throw attempt and ends up on the cage.
Yeah, there was a couple of nice chains from both men there, both active and reactive in the grappling sense. This is really nice. Bradshaw has grown into this fight very well now, I have to say. I think he was caught in the hop in the first round. But here, we're going to see the knee separate again here. He's going to drive his right knee in between. It's going to open up the trip towards the back.
Yeah. Bradshaw just hit a bad spot here. Bradshaw just needs to get some separation and start landing some damage here.
Yeah, Bradshaw is squared up nicely.
His double unders are a real big problem. Head pressure.
I'm biased, obviously, Paul. It's only the fourth event here at Euro Fighting Championships. And maybe when they reach more events, more numbers, more matches, but a credit to Decky McLean in terms of the matchmaking on this event and the last couple. Oh,
yeah,
some nice elevation.
Been spectacular,
but just very enjoyable, very well evenly matched. You know, no mad mismatches, people getting hurt, people getting damaged they shouldn't be getting. Just good, competitive, fair amateur fights. That's what we like to see.
Absolutely, yeah, yeah. It's a stacked card again, as it was the last time, and we are seeing some really, really good matchmaking.
And we are also available to say nice things about your business for a handsome fee.
Very handsome fee. We don't come cheap. Deegan just dragging Bradshaw to the mat. Bradshaw trying to create some space, get himself back to his feet, and does so a little bit. He's grabbing that cage repeatedly and doing it again, and referee Dec Larkin not having a bar of it.
I'd say the best part of a referee's night is being able to slap the hand like that, as I'd say, get off that cage, you.
Yeah, Bradshaw almost did it again, so he thought better of it this time. It's just an instinctive reaction sometimes. That pressure is so intense from Deegan. Looking really, really impressive this evening.
We've had more exciting, eventful fights in terms of striking, but maybe my most technical, enjoyable fight of the evening. Both lads. Deegan seems to be a level ahead on the grappling. Bradshaw did very, very well in the second and third rounds to come back into the fight. Tremendously enjoyable.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to your judges' scorecard for a decision. All three judges score this bout 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision, Ronan Deegan!